Dear students, we are in NCERT class 12 mathematics integrals 7.6 exercise. We are continuing until last class we have finished 9 questions. Okay, 9th question, and this class we are planning to do 6 questions 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, see what they have given in question number 10. Integral sine inverse whole square dx. Integral dx is common. In between sine inverse x whole square is there. See, we are in a, what we can say, not partial fraction, 7.6 exercise, okay, integration by parts. See, how to do this, like, because even if you do sine inverse x into sine inverse x also, multiplication, but sine inverse x integral, we don't know. Differentiation we know, and again 1 by 1, square root of 1 minus x square, you can integrate again, it will come sine inverse x. How to do? Like earlier question, into 1 you quit. Okay, see what I am writing. Now I am keeping into 1. Into 1 dx. Okay, now you take sine inverse x whole square as v, u, 1 as v. Okay, like that. And let me write the formula also. Formula for this by parts. Okay, integration by parts. You see, integral u v dx is equal to u integral v dx, u integral v dx minus integral du by dx integral v dx whole dx. This is the formula. This is the formula for integration by parts. Okay. Okay, see. See here you have to take 1 as v, sine inverse x as u. Why? Because we cannot integrate until now. We don't know. That is why we have taken like this. Okay, see what I am writing. I is equal to u. U is sine inverse x whole square. Sine inverse x whole square integral. 1 dx means dx you can write. Minus integral du by dx means d by dx of sine inverse x whole square. Again integral dx. Why? Because v is 1. Okay, again whole dx. This is the formula. Okay. So what result is going to come? Observe carefully. I is equal to, again I am writing. Okay. Sine inverse x whole square is like that only. Sine inverse x whole square. Okay. And integral dx is x. Shall I keep x outside? Okay. I am keeping x outside. Integral dx is x. Okay. Minus d integral d by dx of sine inverse x. You see, first you consider this as sine inverse x as x. D by dx of x square is 2x. 2 into sine inverse x. Over, no. Again, d by dx of sine inverse x you have to do. D by dx of sine inverse x will give 1 by square root of 1 minus x square. Over. This is over differentiation. But integral, again x will come. Okay, dx. Okay, see how I am converting this. You see, this is over. This case is over. But this, you see here, 2x dx is there, 1 minus x square is there. You take 1 minus x square as t, minus 2x dx will come, dt. Minus, that means plus I am sending inside and keeping plus outside. See how I am converting this. Okay, see, observe carefully. That is equal to x into sine inverse x whole square. This is okay. Minus I am not keeping. Why? Because minus I am sending inside. You see, sine inverse x into 2x minus 2x dx divided by 1 minus x square under root. Is it okay? First you see this minus I have sent inside, minus 2x dx, sine inverse x I have taken. Now you see sine inverse x you take as u, minus 2x dx by 1 minus x square you take as v. This integration v you have to be integrate. This integration is easy. Why? Because you consider 1 minus x square as t. Okay, see how I am converting this now. Okay, see, that is equal to x into sine inverse x whole square plus, shall I take that as I1? Why? Because this is I1. comma, where I1 is equal to integral sine inverse x into minus 2x dx divided by 1 minus x square under root. Okay? Now, how I am tackling this, you see. I1 only we are doing. I am taking 1 minus x square as t. Then dt will be minus 2x dx. Okay. See, again you have to take u. U as sine inverse x. Take. I1 is equal to u sine inverse x integral minus 2x dx by, sorry. Now you need not write minus 2x dx by because dt. You can write dt directly. Dt by root t minus integral d by dx of sine inverse x, you have to write again integral dt by root t. Okay?
Yes.
See, this will come 2 root t. See how I am writing. That is equal to sine inverse x 2 root t. T we will keep afterwards. 2 root t. 2 root t. Okay? 2 root t. Minus integral, this is going to give 1 by square root of 1 minus x square sine inverse x differentiation, but here 2 root t will be there. 2 root t. See, dx only you have to give. Why? Because see, still we have not yet fully converted. Okay, see, now you substitute t, 1 minus x square, write down I1 is equal to sine inverse x into 2 into square root of 1 minus x square minus integral 2 into square root of 1 minus x square divided by 1 minus x square under root dx. Now you see it, 1 minus x square under root, 1 minus x square under root going to get cancelled, these two. Okay? This is not integrable, already over. You see how I am writing this. Sin inverse x r is I am taking, you see, 2 into 1 minus x square under root sin inverse x, okay, and minus 2 integral dx. Is it okay? Why? Because see, 1 minus x square got cancelled, 2 I have taken outside, dx will be there. Integral dx is x, that's all. Write down. That means I1 is equal to 2 into square root of 1 minus x square under root into sin inverse x minus 2x. Why? Because this is going to become x. Integral dx is x. Okay, this I1 value final. This I1 value how to substitute in I. You see, this is I. Okay, write down. I is equal to I value finalization I am doing. I x into sine inverse x whole square plus I1. I1 is the, how much this was? 2 into square root of 1 minus x square under root into sin inverse x minus 2x plus c also you can write. Okay? See here, sin inverse x common also you cannot take. Why? Because this is only sin inverse x, this is square. Okay? I think better you keep like this only. This will be answer for your 10th question. Take this, we will go for 11th question. Okay? See, question number 11. Integral x cos inverse x divided by square root of 1 minus x square dx. Okay? See, which one you have to take? U you have to take as cos inverse x. V you have to take x by square root of 1 minus x square. Why? Because you see, if you take 1 minus x square as t, minus 2x dx will be there. But x dx is there, minus 2 we will keep. Okay? Numerator denominator like that we will keep and do it. Okay? That is the plan. See how I am doing. I am taking cos inverse x as u. You see how I am tackling this? I is equal to u cos inverse x integral v x by 1 minus x square under root tx minus integral d by dx of cos inverse x. D by dx of cos inverse x integral again x by v, x dx by 1 minus x square under root dx. Okay?
Okay.
See, this is the I. See how I am doing. I am keeping this again. I am taking a square root of integral x dx by 1 minus x square as t. You see, I am taking. You see how I am writing this. I1 is equal to integral x dx by 1 minus x square under root. Okay. Here two areas. This is there. I am tackling this and finally I will write this. Okay. See how I am doing. I1 is equal to integral x dx by 1 minus x square under root is there. If you differentiate this after taking it as a t, minus 2x dx will come. But here x dx is there, minus 2x is not there. Then I am keeping minus 2 and again I am keeping minus 2 here. Okay. Minus 1 by 2, minus 2. 2 going to get cancelled, minus minus going to get cancelled. Like that I have kept. Now I am taking t is equal to 1 minus x square. Then minus 2x dx is equal to dt. Okay.
Okay.
Now you see I1 is equal to what is going to happen? Comma, I1 is equal to minus 1 by 2 integral. This one is dt divided by, this is root 2t. Minus 1 by 2, 2 root t. Okay. 2 going to get cancelled. Then I1 value how much? I1 is equal to square root of, see minus is there outside, don't forget. Minus square root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Minus square root of 1 minus x square will be your I1. See two areas you have to write this. This. Again I am writing I is equal to cos inverse x into minus square root of 1 minus x square. Okay. Minus integral d by dx of cos inverse x, you can write minus 1 by 1 minus x square under root. Okay. D by dx of, again this I1 has come, minus into minus square root of 1 minus x square. Finally dx is there. Okay. If you observe carefully, see 1 minus x square going to get cancelled. Okay. But see here also minus. That means minus into minus plus. What will happen? I is going to happen like this. You see, I is equal to cos inverse x minus, I am keeping. This minus I have kept outside. Minus into 1 minus x square minus integral. You see, minus is going to become plus dx. Is it okay?
Yes.
Now you see, I is equal to minus square root of 1 minus x square into cos inverse x. This is first term. Again minus x plus c. See, don't think much about plus c, but you see minus x. Is it okay? Okay. Now you can take common of this minus. See, finally, I is equal to minus, if I take common, square root of 1 minus x square into cos inverse x plus c. Okay? Like this, you can conclude this. Okay? Take this. This is the answer for your 11th question. We will go for 12th question. Okay. See, question number 12. Integral x into secant square x dx. Okay. Integration by parts you have to do. You have to consider product of two terms are there. One you have to take as u, one you have to take as v. Two functions. See, how you take, do you take secant square as x as u? No. Why? Because see, we know d by dx of tan x is equal to secant square x. Integral secant square x is equal to tan x. That means you take this as v. Easily you can integrate it. Okay. Like that you have to think. Okay. See how I am doing. I is equal to, I am taking x as u, x integral secant square x dx minus integral d by dx of x integral secant square x dx whole dx. Okay? Okay, write down. I is equal to x into, you see, integral secant square x is tan x. Minus integral d by dx of x is 1. 1 you write or don't write, no difference. 1 into integral again tan x dx. Okay? Now, do you know tan x, integral tan x value? Yes. Log secant x or minus log cos x. I am writing first, you see. X tan x minus integral tan x is log modulus secant x plus c. Okay. See, this is normal plus log secant x. See, already minus is there. If you want to remove this minus, you convert it into cos, log cos, minus log cos. That is equal to, I is equal to x tan x plus log cos x plus c. Okay? Integral tan x is equal to log secant x modulus or else minus log cos x. Minus log cos x I have written. Okay? This is a solution for your 12th question. Take this, we'll go for 13th question. Okay, see, question number 13. Integral tan inverse x dx. Here two functions are not there. Then how to do? Simple, you take into 1. Tan inverse x into 1. Okay, tan inverse x into 1, if you take, automatically see what is to be taken u and what is to be taken v, you think logically. If you take tan inverse x as u, easily you can do differentiation. D by dx of tan inverse x is 1 by square root, 1 by 1 plus x square. Okay? Integration of 1 we can do easily. Integral dx is x. Okay? Like that you have to analyze. Okay, see. Okay. Take this. See how I am writing this. Integral u. U means tan inverse x. See how I am writing. I is equal to tan inverse x u. Integral v dx, dx, why, because 1 dx, minus integral du by dx, that means d by dx of tan inverse x, okay, again integral v dx, v means 1, 1 means 1 dx, okay, tx, that is equal to, okay, see, this will come x, x tan inverse x, write down, x tan inverse x, okay, minus, d by dx of tan inverse x is, see, integral you have to write, d by dx of tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus x square, 1 by 1 plus x square, okay, what about again integral dx, x, into x dx, okay, proceed, why, because integral, this, how to tackle, I am tackling, you see, x, tan inverse x minus integral x dx by 1 plus x square. See what I am doing. I want to take 1 plus x square as t, then dt will be 2x dx. But here x dx is there. I am keeping 2 here and 1 by 2 here. 2 to void get cancelled again. This equation will be normalized or expression. Okay. See, again I am taking 1 plus x square is equivalent to t, then dt will be 2x dx. Okay? Okay. Write down then. Again, that is equal to I is equal to. I is equal to x into tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 integral dt by t. Okay? Minus 2, sorry, 2x dx will be dt. 1 by 1 plus x square is, sorry, 1 plus x square is t. Okay, write down. That is equal to x into tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 log t plus c. Okay, log t plus c. What about t? 1 plus x square, write down. That is equal to x tan inverse x minus 1 by 2 log of 1 plus x square plus c. See, 1 plus x square you can keep bracket also, but R modulus also. Modulus is a standard practice. See here, even if you need not keep modulus. Why? Because x square is always a positive number. Positive number plus 1 is positive number. You can keep bracket also, but if you are having practice of keeping modulus, then you keep modulus. This is a standard practice of keeping modulus. Okay? Okay. Take this. We will go for 14th question. Okay. See, question number 14. Integral x log x whole square dx. Definitely we have to take log x square as u. Why? Because this differentiation you can do, integration log x we have not done. We will do after the completion of this exercise. Okay. See how I am tackling this question. Okay. I is equal to लॉग एक्स होल स्क्वायर इंटरग्रल एक्स डी एक्स वाई बिकॉज वी विल बी एक्स लॉग एक्स स्क्वायर इज यू माइनस इंटरग्रल डी यू बाई डी एक्स दैट मीन डी बाई डी एक्स ऑफ लॉग एक्स होल स्क्वायर अगेन इंटरग्रल वी डी एक्स इंटरग्रल एक्स डी एक्स देन होल डी एक्स यू अंडरस्टैंड ओके हाँ ओके नाउ प्रोसीड फर्दर I is equal to see x dx is x square by 2 write down first x square by 2 x square by 2 into log x whole square this side is over story okay minus integral d by dx of log x whole square you see first consider log x as x d by dx of x square is 2x then write 2 into log x again d by dx of log x is 1 by x Now differentiation is over. Integral x square by 2 dx outside dx x square by 2 over. Okay. Why I have written x into x? Why? Because I want to cancel one x. I want to cancel this 2 also. Again, you take log x into x only. Don't take x log x. Okay. See how I am writing. That is equal to x square by 2. Into log x whole square minus integral log x into x dx log x into x dx why because see again you have to take log x as u only why because log x integration we will do afterwards okay that is not a big thing we can do but in exercise it is not there that is why I am going to finish after exercise 7.6 exercise last day okay see again you write down that is equal to x square by 2 log x whole square minus see now this is like integral u v dx I am taking as u means log x write down log x okay see minus is there I think we take this as I1 why because we may get some mistake I1 I is equal to x square by 2 log x whole square minus I1 then I1 separately I am doing afterwards we will keep minus y because all minus I we have to keep okay or else we have to put a bracket or something like I1 is equal to integral log x into x dx that is equal to now you take u as log x integral x dx minus integral d by dx of log x Integral v is how much? X dx whole dx. Okay.
Okay.
Come back. See, we are doing I1 only. After completion of I1, again we will go for I. Okay. Write down. I1 is equal to x dx is integral x square by 2 into log x. Okay. Minus integral. D by dx of log x is 1 by x. Okay? D by dx of log x is 1 by x. Over. Again, integral x, x square by 2. Then x into x by 2 dx. Why I have written? I want to cancel this. Okay? Now, how can you write this? You can write this like this. You see, x square by 2 into log x minus 1 by 2 I am keeping outside. Integral x dx is it okay observe carefully x dx 2 taken outside minus also outside is there 1 x got cancelled x dx okay now you see x square by 2 that's all right now that is equal to x square by 2 log x minus 1 by 2 into x square by 2 okay that means x minus x square by 4 it is going to happen okay see outside minus is there okay then see first one is going to become minus second one is going to become plus minus of minus okay that you keep in your mind write down I is equal to finalization I is x square by 2 log x whole square minus I1 means minus x square by 2 log x. Minus 1 by 2 is there, but already outside minus is there. That means plus x square by 4 plus c. Okay? See, you cannot take common x square by 2 also. No, you keep like this only. Okay? This is the answer for your 14th question. Take this, we'll go for 15th question. Okay? See, question number 15. Integral x square plus 1 into log x dx. Here also, you take log x as u. Entire x square plus 1 you take as v. Okay? See how I am tackling this question. I am taking log x as u. I is equal to log x integral x square plus 1 dx minus integral d by dx of log x integral x square plus 1 into dx or dx. Okay? Proceed further. Why? Because see, x square plus 1 is this. See, even you can do separate or directly also you can write. Why? Because integral x square plus 1 is x cube by 3. Integral 1 dx means x, that's all. Okay, write down. I is equal to log x. Okay? Log x. You see, x cube by 3 plus x. Integral x square dx is equal to x cube by 3. Integral 1 dx is equal to x. That's all. Okay. This is over. Yes. Minus integral d by dx of log x is 1 by x. Keep 1 by x into integral x square plus 1. Same thing you keep. X cube by 3 plus x. But you keep bracket. Why? Because here entire thing you have to keep in bracket and dx. Okay. Now wait and observe. Here this case is over story. But here 1 by x you have to send inside. X going to get cancelled. Here x square is going to become, x cube is going to become x square. Okay. See how I am writing this again. That is equal to log x into x cube by 3 plus x. This is 1 minus integral x square by 3. Plus 1 dx. Is it okay? First you observe carefully. Set. If you send x inside x square, it is going to become, again it is going to become 1. X square by 2, x square by 3 plus 1. Okay. Now you do again that integration. This integration. That is easy. You see, I is equal to log x into x cube by 3 plus x minus x square integral dx, x cube by 3, see already 3 is there. Okay, I will write again, once again. You see, x cube by 3 into 3, 1 3 and another 3, okay, minus. See, minus is for both, plus is there means again this also minus. Minus integral 1 dx, x plus c. Okay, now you finalize, you can finalize, you see, I is equal to x cube by 3 plus x into log x, okay, minus x cube by 9 minus x plus c. Okay, this is answer for your 15th question. Okay, see, we will stop this class here. From question number 16 onwards, we will try to solve in the next class. Okay, thank you very much.